Hello statistics students, in this tutorial we will be looking at the week 8 tutorial questions. Let's look at the first question. Uranium decays slowly by emitting alpha particles. The half-life of U-235, this is the nomenclature for uranium, U-235, is 25,000 years. An uranium atom is picked from a pile of uranium-235. Let's assume that we have so many infinite number of uranium atoms, and from that we picked one particular atom. The probability of survival of the atom after k half-lives is given by the equation f of k equals c by 2 power k. Find the value of c for which f of k is PMF. First of all, if you look at this question, they were saying that half-life of U-235 is 25,000 years. The first question would be, what is half-life? Half-life is the time taken for uranium for half of its atoms to be decaying. That means that the number of uranium atoms will be reduced to half after this half-life of 25,000 years. Suppose there were n atoms of uranium. Initially, let's say time t equals 0. So when time t equals to 25,000 years, the number of atoms of this uranium would be equals to n by 2. After 50,000 years, this n by 2 still reduces to n by 4, further reduces to n by 4. And after 75,000 years, it will reduce to n by 8. N by 4 divided by 2, which is n by 8. So this is what half-life means. So what they were asking is, the probability of survival of the atom after k half-life is given by the equation f of k equals c by 2 power k. Let's look at this expression. So initially we have n atoms, and after one half-life it would be n by 2. So that means that only half of the atoms were remained. So the probability for an atom to be surviving after one half-life would be 1 by 2, since only half of the elements were left over. And if you want to look at after like two half-lives, it would be 1 by 2 whole square. After three half-lives, it would be 1 by 2 whole cube. Because after 3 half-lives, only 1/8 of the atoms were remaining. So for this atom to be surviving, the probability would be equals to only 1 by 8, because already 7 by 8 of the atoms after 3 half-lives will be decaying. So the probability after 3 half-lives would be equals to 1 by 2 whole cube. You can see the pattern here. After k half-lives, let's assume initially there were n atoms. After k half-lives, atoms left over would be, or atoms alive would be equals to n by 2 power k. Because after each half-life, they will be reduced by half. So after k half-lives, they would be reduced to n by 2 power k. Only these many atoms would be alive. The remaining n minus n by 2 power k atoms would not be alive. So for the probability, if you look at this, the probability of survival of the atom after k half-life is given as c by 2 power k. So the probability would be equals to the number of atoms left, n by 2 power k, divided by total number of atoms initially, that is n. So the probability would be equals to 1 by 2 power k, the probability of survival after k half-life. So if you look at the expression there, this is c by 2 power k, we will be equating to this. So c by 2 power k equals to 1 by 2 power k. This implies c is equals to 1. Find the value of C for which f of k is a PMF. The probability mass function for it to be PMF, the sum of all this should be equals to 1. That is half plus 1 by 2 square plus 1 by 2 power 4 plus 1 by 2 power 8 plus and so on. All this should be equals to 1. Let's see if we, since we are substituting C equals to 1 here, if this is valid. As you have seen from the geometric progression, this is similar to that where A is equals to half and R is equals to half. So this should be equals to, the sum of this would be equals to A by 1 minus R, that is equals to 1 by 2 by 1 minus 1 by 2. That is equals to 1 by 2 divided by 1 by 2, that is equals to 1. So we can see that the sum of all these terms, all these infinite terms would be equals to 1. So this is satisfying PMF and for C is equals to 1. So the first question is, for what value of C for which f of k is a PMF? For C equals to 1, it would be PMF. For the given value of C, find the probability of survival of the atom after 10 half-lives. That also we have discussed here. The probability of survival after k half-lives is given by 1 by 2 power k. They are asking probability of survival for k is equals to 10. That would be equals to 1 by 2 power 10. This is the second question answer. 1 by 2 power 10. Thank you.